Dear viewers, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows a case of anencephaly with the pregnancy of about 17 weeks. You can see the fetus. Fetal cardiac activity is visible. You can see the fetal abdominal circumference. Now you can see the fetal cardiac activity. Femur, both of the femurs are visible. Now you can see the pregnancy measures about 17 weeks. Anencephaly is the absence of large part of brain and skull. And you can see this is a normal fetal ultrasound performed at 17 weeks gestation. These are both the hands. The development of the brain and nervous system begins early in the fetal development. Anencephaly is one of the most common neural tube defects. Neural tube defects are birth defects that affect the tissue and become this. Affect the tissue that becomes the spinal cord and brain. You can see the placenta is posteriorly attached. Now, anencephaly occurs early in the development of an unborn baby. It results when the upper part of the neural tube defects, neural tube fails to close. The exact cause is not known. Possible causes include, you can see both the eyes of the fetus, but the skull bone is missing. Now the possible causes include environmental toxins and low intake of folic acid by the mother during pregnancy. In nearly all the fetuses with anencephaly, the movements are qualitatively abnormal. They are forceful, jerky in character, and are of large amplitude. Anencephaly is a lethal diagnosis, incompatible with sustained life. It has been understood that if an anencephaly fetus is live born, death will soon be imminent. Several studies have reported anencephaly to be 100% lethal in the first year of the life. Anencephaly is a lethal congenital anomaly that can be detected on ultrasound as early as 11 week of gestation. If some amount of neural tissue is present, the condition is termed exencephaly. Polyhydramnios is usually associated with neural tube defects. No treatment option is available for anencephaly. You can see the fetus. No other abnormality is visible except the missing of the part of the brain and skull bone. Now these are the legs of the fetus. Theoretically, the anencephaly can be diagnosed as early as 8 weeks. However, it can be missed in the first trimester. There is 100% accuracy in the second trimester for this diagnosis by ultrasound. One study shows sonography alone was 97% sensitive and 100% specific in diagnosing an open neural tube defects. By ultrasound, the appearance will resemble Mickey Mouse ears. Additionally, a measurement from the top to head to the rump. Crown rump length or CRL is significantly reduced in affected fetuses in the first trimester. Again, you can see the skull bone is missing. Of those fetuses with anencephaly, a small portion will die while still in the uterus. Intrauterine fetal demise or stillbirth, approximately 25% will have excessive amniotic fluid around the fetus. Polyadromnias may cause extra stretching of the uterus, resulting in preterm contractions. An infant born with anencephaly has some or most of the brain missing. These infants are unconscious, cannot feel, and are usually blind and deaf. Infants with anencephaly are stillborn in about 75% of the cases. You can find some important information in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. If you do like this video, please click the like button. Thanks.